grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Creator and Redeemer, as you planned the wedding at Cana in Galilee by the presence of your Son, and so by his presence now bring your joy to this wedding. Look in favor upon Brandon and Delaney, and grant that they are rejoicing in all your gifts. May at length celebrate with Christ the marriage feast which has no end. Amen. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Mother and I? You may be seated. I'd like to share a couple lessons that Delaney and Brandon picked out, and the first one is from Genesis chapter 2, verses 18 through 24. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." And so out of the ground the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air, and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was his name. The man gave names to all cattle, and to the birds of the air, and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. And so the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. And then he took one of his ribs, and he closed up his place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. And the man said, "This, alas, is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore, a man leaves his father and his mother and cleaves to his wife." So far the reading of the first lesson. Second lesson today for the celebration recorded in Paul's letter to the Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, I do not have love. I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. But give away all my possessions. And if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful, arrogant or rude. It does not insist upon its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part, but when the complete comes, the partial comes to me. And I was a child. I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. And when I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part. Then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide these two. The greatest. So far the reading of the scripture. Well, this is the day the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be